We're here outside Parnell Park following a dramatic AIB Leinster Club Championship semi-final. Kilmacud Croke squeezing through against Portlaoise, 117-38 the final score. Johnny McGee, how are you feeling after that? That was dramatic, wasn't it?
Yeah, feeling okay now. Yeah, very dramatic. Made hard work of it. But look, happy that we got the win and put ourselves into a Leinster final. That was the objective. How we went about it, probably we'll look at it. But look, the objective was to get to a Leinster final, and we're there now. So look, we look forward to it in 2 weeks' time.
Pat Burke, immediately after the game, you said that Portlaoise went toe to toe with you. You're kind of used to tight games, but normally it's because a team are sitting back. They didn't. You just went at it today, didn't you?
Yeah, it was really enjoyable from that perspective. It was 15 on 15, both teams trying to play football. They have some exceptional footballers. They're really able to move the ball through the hand and by foot, and that makes a massive difference. So it was a really enjoyable game to play in. I'd say it wasn't the easiest game to stand on the sideline and manage, but from our perspective, yeah, really enjoyable.
What were you thinking maybe 10 minutes from the end when Portlaoise were getting on top?
I just felt we just needed to kind of move the ball a little bit quicker. We took probably a bit naive, took the ball into contact a bit too much. We coughed up some easy ball, whereas normally we haven't done that. We've been very good on the ball. I think we made life difficult for ourselves. But look, I think they came out, set their stall very early in the second half. They went man to man, pushed up, squeezes, and I knew that we once we got over that difficult period, that we managed the game at times very well, and then other times we didn't manage it very well. But look, I think the lads, in fairness, look, you can't prepare the lads for that kind of experience at the end, and that's the type of stuff that's you want character to step up, and we've spoken about it. When things happen you can't control, you have to use your initiative as a footballer and trust yourselves, and that's what they did today. And the younger lads stepped up today, some nice performance, and look, Davey, massive save at the end, and that's his job. That's his goalkeeper, save shots and goal, and that's what he did. So I'm delighted that he pulled off the save.
And Pat, everyone in this team can play. I mean, when you needed an out ball, everyone was looking for it. Anytime anyone got the ball, even when they were surrounded by Portlaoise players, they looked comfortable under that pressure. A lot of that is down to the work, I suppose, you do as players, but a lot of that, I guess, is down to the confidence the management team give you.
Yeah, it's a mixture. It's the training we've been doing. It's been all about the ball. When Johnny, Badger and Shane, Paul and Robbie came.
You didn't really do a pre-season per se, did you? Everything you did was with the ball.
We haven't ran once. It's been all football. Yeah, all football the whole time. So I think that's made a difference. It's brought us on confidence-wise. It's allowed maybe older lads like myself to continue playing because we're not being dogged, laps around the pitch or anything like that. It's a mixture. I think the lads have a lot of talent. We have a lot of talent throughout the team. And they're all very comfortable on the ball. So, yeah, the management just brought that side of players out.
Croke's last provincial title was back in 2010. You're 37. Did you think that the chance was 35? Sorry, 35. Okay, I've been misinformed. I've given you 2 years. Well, that game today put 2 years on us all, I think. Come here. Did you think that it was gone? You were never going to get back to a provincial final?
Probably on a personal level, yeah. I always was confident the club would get back, just the amount of lads coming through. I think they've been trying to retire me there for a couple of years, so I wasn't confident of getting back myself, but just absolutely delighted to be there. But we have an awful lot of young lads on the team, and they should be aspiring to get to Leinster finals every couple of years, that's the aspiration. I won't be there for them, but we'll make the most of the game in a couple of weeks' time.
Johnny, as a manager, you're co-manager of this team, obviously, with Robbie Brennan. How has it felt to get to a Leinster final? Because you had a lot of success in this competition as a player, and now you're looking for the trophy as a manager.
Yeah, look, come here, to be honest with you, it's about giving the lads the tools to go and express themselves and to play football. As Pat alluded to there, you're wanting to get back to the Leinster finals. And look, we've given the lads the confidence to go and play football. And that's what we're here to do, look, is to kind of give the lads our experience of what we've been through as former players and get them to go and create their own bit of history, and that's been a big thing for us, is that the history of the club, and then obviously the standards that were imposed on me as a young lad when I came through from the likes of his father, Peter Ward and Robbie Leahy, and that's what we're looking at is pass on the mantle to these lads in order for them to go and express themselves and go and win for the Kilmacud, and that's our biggest objective, was to kind of give them the tools. But look, they're the lads who go across the white line at the end of the day, and as they showed the very last 5 minutes, the character that they showed to get that result was massive against a very, very good side.
And it's a good side in the final as well, Mullinocta. It's a club of 4,000 up against a club who come from a population of about 450 or something like that in the final. It couldn't be any bigger of a contrast, could it?
Sure. Look, the story will go bigger and bigger. It'll be 20,000 by the time, and it'll be 200 by the time the match comes around. But look, at the end of the day, it's 15 players against 15 players, and it's 60 odd minutes, and that's it. That's it. You know, we'll pay them the respect that they deserve, the same way we've paid everybody respect with every match we play this year. We haven't looked past any game, taken game by game, and I didn't know until the lads, some of the press, told me there who we were playing. So, you know, that's it's all about ourselves, really.
Pat Burke and Johnny McGee, thank you very much for joining us here at Parnell Park, where Kilmacud Crokes have beaten Portlaoise in the AIB Leinster Club semi-final. A dramatic game it was as well, 117-38 the final score.